Hello friends, this is Raj Sastri from Raj Option Trading. Today is October 6, 2021. I want to talk about top performing healthcare stocks. As you all know, broader market is having some trouble here, but typically healthcare stocks are a little more defensive and they will do well no matter how the economy is doing. So with that, let's look at a few top healthcare stocks to buy right now. So before you go there, let's quickly look at a market update and see how futures are doing. So from a market perspective, as you can see here, S&P 500 is a little bit in a downward trend here, pointing to a lower opening today. Be careful, generally the trend is lower off late. That's why we have to go after very good names, especially healthcare names are great in these types of market. And then we got your NASDAQ 100, which also has some biotech names here. I think it's also in a downward trend here, pointing to a lower opening. And then we got here Dow Jones Industrial Average. And as you can see here, it's also pointing to a lower opening here. So that's why we got to pick up some quality names and go from there. And then we got a Russell 2000, same story, pointing to a lower opening. So with that, let's jump in. And also before I jump in, let's look at how broader healthcare index is doing. So for that, let's go in here and look at a chart here. Look at XLV, which is a healthcare sector ETF. As you look at XLV here, even though broader market is dropping a little bit, healthcare sector is really, you know, showing a hammer here, trying to tell you, here what, there may be a turnaround in the healthcare area. So I think typically we have to look at some of the great healthcare names and take advantage. And if you look at XBI, one more ETF on the biotech side of the house. And as we look through XBI here, and it's also in a downward trend, but typically these are, you know, great, bigger, better candidates as market is dropping. So we should look at some of these names here and pick up some good names in the biotech and healthcare area. And stick with them, you know, because they tend to do well, you know, in these type of markets. So with that, let's jump in here and look at market update. We already did that. Look at top performing healthcare stocks and also look at healthcare stocks with the rule of 40. These companies have got great sales growth and gross margin and satisfy rule of 40. And also low RSI tells you it's a good entry point. And look at great stocks with the rule of 40 and positive net margin. In these type of market, we should look at great candidates with a positive net margin also. And then last but not least, let's look at great stocks with the rule of 40, low RSI, as well as, you know, where insiders and institutions are buying. This could be a great opportunity for us to buy along with these insiders and institutions because they know so much more about these companies. So with that, let's jump in here and get started. You know, from a top level stock perspective, you know, these are the stocks where we have great sales growth and gross margin, handily beat rule of 40. All of these are healthcare stocks top performing. If you look at the performance in 1 year, a BNGO here, little known company, $5, has done 723%. And we got SENS, nice, 721%. And from there, it's a descending order, as you can see here. So all these stocks have done great in 1 year. And as you see here, right now, they're having a little trouble. That's why RSI is a little bit lower here. As you look through here, shorter term, 5 day, 10 day, you see more reds here. Longer term, you see green. That's why we should take a look at these candidates with the nice sales growth, nice gross margin, and stocks are having some short term trouble here, and pick up some of those candidates here. And as usual, you know, watch what insiders are doing, what institutions are doing. In many cases, like BNGO, SENS, institutions are buying, they're signaling, hey, you know what, there's a bottom here, I'm willing to buy in and jump in and buy some. And look at BNTX, CDMO, we got LTCX, LCTX, and PACB, Tilray, all these stocks we have institutions buying, signaling a turnaround is in the play. And as you scan through here, many of these have got low RSI, tells you stock is oversold, like 40, 41, 32, very low RSI here. And as you scan through, some of these stocks have got high short ratio. They can signal a short squeeze type scenario, like BNGO here, SENS, and we got DVAX and so on and so forth. I think these are the good candidates to really buy slowly into this weakness and take advantage of short squeeze type scenario. Look at DermTech here. You know, this used to be a big time SPAC play a while ago. Nice sales growth, nice gross margin. Look at the short ratio here, very high short ratio, 22%. It's showing some turnaround here, trying to crush these short sellers here. So I think these are the great candidates. You should look at these stocks and buy them slowly and take it from there. And we got few more same criteria. Rule of 40 satisfied, low RSI. Great stocks to buy now. Look at what institutions are doing. For example, Bosch. It's a great company. I think they got a lot of eye care type products here. As you scan through, nice sales growth here. Institutions are buying heavily. Stock is trying to show a small turnaround here. I think it's a good one to buy. Take advantage of this institution buying here. Even stock is sold off and you could take it from there. And as you scan through, we got SIEN, heavy institution buying here. Stock has got nice sales growth and it's also turning around. So typically when insiders or institutions buy, stock tend to turn around. That typically signals a bottom in the stock many times. And then you got your MYVOV, same story, $20 stock, heavy insider buying. As you scan through, this is not turning around yet. It could be good to buy slowly. It also has a high short ratio. That's a good candidate for a turnaround here. And look at one more here, SIEN, high short ratio. You could take advantage of that. If you're an option person or an option trader, pay attention to IV percentile. When IV percentile is high, stock, great quality stock like Eli Lilly, high IV percentile, you could take advantage and sell some put option underneath the stock price and earn some premium that way. And same story with the SYNH. I think it's a nice high short ratio here. You could take advantage and buy some put option or a put spread underneath stock price and earn some premium. Same story, Agilent. It's a quality stock. Right now, IV percentile is high. You could take advantage, buy some put options under stock price. And same story with the LH LabCorp. I like this company also. I've seen this for a long time. High IV percentile here. You could sell some put option here and go from there. Next, we got few more companies. Here, we are going after net margin positive. Great sales growth, great gross margin, and net margin is greater than 10%. These are the great stocks under sale right now, and we should really look at buying them slowly so that way we don't rush too much. So as you scan through, top of the list is Moderna. COVID vaccine play. They got a lot of drugs in their pipeline, especially around the cancer and oncology indications. As you can see, your stock has been dropping off of late, but showing some small turnaround. I would slowly buy Moderna into this weakness and take it from there. And we got InMode, one of my favorite stock. Stock has been falling off. Had a nice stock split a while ago. I would take advantage and buy InMode slowly and add to portfolio. As you can see here, InMode is turning around in one day. You know, that's a great indication here. And we got a few more here, ORGO, BNTX, and so on and so forth. You could take advantage of this. I love Align Technologies. You know, many people want their teeth to be straight and have this technology from Align Technologies. Stock has been dropping off late, trying to turn around here. Low RSI, 29. I think we should take advantage and buy some Align. If you can't buy stock outright, you could buy some call spread or call option, or even buy one stock in a socket away. That's also good. And we got a few more here. I love stocks like Bruker here, and Progyny is also good. And Eli Lilly, one of the great stock here. You could buy Eli Lilly on this downtick here and take advantage, sock it away into retirement for portfolio. And you can look through, we got Agilent, again a great story. LabCorp, this stock trades up and down wildly. Right now it's down, as you can see here. We could take advantage of this and buy slowly. And I love Intuitive Surgical, great robotics type play here. Our stock is down right now, and I think we should take advantage of ISRG here and buy some slowly. RSI is just 41. And look at Danaher. Danaher is a great stock here into health life sciences area. As you can see here, right now it's sold off with a low RSI. I would buy quality stock like Danaher here and take advantage. And then you've got a few more here. Medical device play, Edward Life Sciences, very good stock here. We could take advantage of this also. And this one also has a high IV percentile. You could sell some put spread under the stock price or put option and take advantage of this Edward Life Science high IV percentile here. And we got PKI, AbbVie. AbbVie is also one of my favorite stocks here. It's a great stock, has been down off late. We could take advantage, buy some AbbVie. And we've got Dexcom. Again, I love Dexcom. It's into diabetics area, medical device stock. Stock is dropping low RSI here. It's trying to turn around in the lower term, a shorter term. I would take advantage, buy some Dexcom also. Look at all these stocks. They've pulled down nicely from 52-week high. And they got low RSI. And look at the sales growth and gross margin, also positive net margin. You know, these companies have got what it takes to withstand this downturn. You could take advantage, slowly buy this, accumulate in them in your portfolio, and take it from there. And we got a few more with the same, you know, rule of 40 satisfied, low RSI, net margin is greater than 10%. These stocks can also withstand the downturn. I love stocks like Thermo Fisher here. It's a great life sciences stock here. Nice sales growth, nice gross margin, and stock is RSI is low here. You could pick up slowly and go from there. And there are stocks like Pfizer here. I think it's a great play with the COVID-19. Stock is down with the, you know, RSI, low RSI right now. You could buy some slowly into this weakness here. And as you look through, you know, a lot of these companies, I love this. I own this personally, like SYK Strickler. It's again a great, you know, healthcare play here. And DGX, it's something similar to LabCorp here. They are also down here. You could take advantage of that, buy them slowly. And we got Medtronic and Illumina, both are medical device step play here. You could buy them slowly and take advantage. Medtronic is a great company. It trades along with the, the medical device stocks. I think I love this one too. Right now, low RSI. We could buy some Medtronic here. As you scan through here, we got a lot of great stocks here. You could look at them, buy slowly, and take advantage. Option buyers and sellers, look at IV percentile. High IV percentile means you could sell some put option underneath, and also you could do other strategies, take advantage of RSI levels also. And with that, I think we should look at some of these names here. Many of these are down big time. I love Abbott Labs also here. Stock has been down off late. I think it's a good one to buy slowly and pick up. And next we'll look at few more. These are the stocks where rule of 40 is satisfied, meaning, you know, these are great stocks with the growth. As you can see here, many of these have got nice sales growth and low RSI. Many of them have got low RSI here. And also insiders or institutions buying. So these are the great stocks where there's some conviction from insiders and institutions. Look here, we got all these stocks here, BNGO, SENS, and so on and so forth. Very high institution buying. ESPR has got high insider buying. So that tells you stock is trying to turn around, and these insiders and institutions have got some conviction here. So you could take a look at these stocks here, buy them slowly into this weakness, and wait for a nice pullback, bounce back here. Look at the short ratio. In many of these stocks, there is a high short ratio. So when the short ratio is high, and when insiders or institutions are buying, that tells you that it's a good opportunity for a swing trading type opportunity here. And many of these stocks are slowly turning around, like BNGO. There's a one-day positive sign here. And SENS, it's trying to turn around here. And many of these stocks are trying to turn around in shorter term. That tells you probably a turnaround in play, and we could take advantage. And we got stocks like BHC, again, a great healthcare stock. We got Tilray here, and we could take buy some of these stocks into this weakness. And Amwell has been down for a long time. So as right now, high short ratio, institutions are buying Amwell. That's also a good one to buy slowly and take it from there. And we got a few more here, 23andMe. This stock is completely undervalued right now. I think we should buy slowly, take advantage of 23andMe. They have a great database of genetics and some of these indications. It tells you where you're from based on the genetics or genes. I think it's trying to turn around here. That's a good one to buy, socket away. And we got a few more here like Zlab, NARI, NovoCure, one of my favorite stock here, down right now. RSI is 22. Tells you completely oversold here. You could buy some NovoCure here and sock it away. And you could look at stocks like BDSI, again, a good one, down big time, and MDXG, InSmed. All of these stocks have got high institution buying, as you can see here, or high insider buying. And low RSI, you could sock it away. And many of these stocks have got rule of 40, as you can see here, ICLR, Zlab, and so on and so forth. You could take advantage of this and buy some, sock it away, and go from there. And we got one more here. You know, look at the institution and insider buying here. Very nice percentage here. And these can turn around as you go forward. And I like stocks like NNOX here. It's down for a long time, due for a pullback. Nice institution buying here. And we got stocks like EPIX, both insiders as well as institutions buying. That's a good sign here. And we got Berkeley, Doximity, one of my absolute favorite here. Stock has been pulling back off late, low RSI. We could buy some Doximity at these levels and take it from there. So even Butterfly, it's a low price stock here. Institutions are buying heavily. We could take advantage and buy some you know, Butterfly here and take it from there. Look at, you know, what the sales growth and gross margin, FLDM as an example. Nice sales growth, nice gross margin. You could take advantage of that and buy. And same story with MPLN here. And also look at the IV, the short ratio here. High short ratio means these candidates can, you know, give you a short, the squeeze type scenario. Take advantage of those, especially with the one with the lower RSI. For example, BLI, I think it's already had a little bit run here. RSI is a little higher. You could buy slowly, but you could focus on other candidates with the lower RSI. So with that, thank you very much. This kind of tells you about when to buy and sell stocks. Look for RSI levels before you buy. That'll make sure you'll get a nice entry point, typically RSI less than 55 or so. Also look at rule of 40, low debt. Look for catalysts like short ratio, institution buying, or insider buying. For options buyers and sellers, look at these guidelines here. If you're a call option buyer, look for a low RSI and low IV percentile. If you want to sell put options, you want RSI to be low, you want IV percentile to be high, so that way you bring in some good premium. If you're a call seller, you want RSI to be high, meaning stock is really overbought, due for a pullback, and you want IV percentile to be high, so you can earn enough premium. And if you want to buy put option because you're bearish, look for high RSI. You want the stock to be overbought and low IV percentile, so that way you don't pay too much money to buy put option. These are some quick cheat sheet for you. So with that, thank you very much. Happy investing and trading. Please subscribe.